In Genesis, when God created Adam, God told Adam, take care of the garden. He created everything. And then he told, take care of the garden. God made Adam to be gardener in the Garden of Eden. Read it for yourself. Genesis chapter 2, verse number 15. Then the Lord God took the man and put him into the Garden of Eden to cultivate in and keep it. The Lord God commanded the man, saying, from any tree of the garden you may eat freely, but from the tree of the good of the knowledge of good and evil you shall not eat, for in the day that you eat from it you will surely die. So God gave a job to Adam. What was the job God gave to Adam? To be a gardener, to cultivate it, to dress it, to take care of it, to watch over it. I asked this question to God. God, there were no thorns in the beginning. There were no weeds. Everything was perfect. Soil was perfect. Seed was perfect. Atmosphere was perfect. Perfectly perfecto. Everything was perfect. Then what was there to take care? Why did you tell him to take care? What was there that he had to take care? Then I was reading this in different version. He was supposed to cultivate it. He was supposed to dress it. He was supposed to take care of it. Meaning, there was nothing wrong. There were no weeds to pull out. There were no thorns to prune. But what choice God gave was, you grow it in the way you like it. You grow it in the way you like it. You want to grow only lilies one row? You grow it. You want to grow only orchids? You grow it. You want to make a full circle of roses? You grow it. You like mangoes? You grow all the mango trees. You grow, you design, you cultivate, you have a structure and frame for the garden. So God told, I give you control. You grow as per your choice. I have created you in my image. You can create things like me. So you can procreate. You can create. Create means what? Not creating things like God. From the created things of God, we can procreate. We can design it. We can make man-made things. Correct? That's what God told to Adam. So God gave the job to Adam to be a gardener. So as I was meditating, I got this revelation. The entire Bible is the story of two gardens. Isn't it? The entire Bible is the story of two gardens. One is the story of Garden of Eden. The other one is the story of the Garden of Gethsemane. In Garden of Eden, Adam lost it. Adam didn't grow it properly, didn't cultivate it properly. Adam chose wrong seeds, grew wrong plants. Adam missed it. But the last Adam in the Garden of Gethsemane, praise the Lord, the last Adam in the Garden of Gethsemane, he chose wisely. He grew wisely. Amen. The Garden of Eden is talking about creation. The Garden of Gethsemane is talking about redemption. Amen. If you see, even now, astrophysics, scientists, all the research people, they are doing so much of research. They have hardly found information about astrophysics. Hardly they are still discovering and finding the things about the human body, human brain. There is so much to discover. They don't know how sky works, how the ocean has a border and the ocean doesn't come from there. There is so much to discover. They still don't know. This universe, this creation, God has given only one chapter. Only one chapter. Genesis chapter 1. Everything it talks about creation. And the whole Bible is talking about redemption of Jesus. It's talking about the Son. It's talking about the work of Jesus. See how much God loves His people? He loves you. That means He created everything for you. That's why creation is only one chapter. Redemption is all the other chapters. Redemption is everything what Jesus has done, the whole Bible is talking about. The Garden of Eden is one chapter, but the Garden of Gethsemane story is what the whole Bible is laying out. Genesis to Revelation talking about one person and his finished work. His name is Jesus. Amen.